I'm going to be talking about self-motivation, the God factor. And I will want to stand on what the pastor already started. You know, every time we talk about motivation, it is not every time, every day that you need motivation. Yes, motivation comes when at some point in your life you've reached sort of end of your road. Motivation is needed when the people you feel you have seem to abandon you. Motivation comes when you think that there is no more hope for you. I mean, if you look back and you want to compare your present situation with people who had the same thing years or days or months back, and you know how they ended, and your mind simply tells you you're not going anywhere. And in your natural mind, the easiest thing to do would be to throw in the towel, to just back off, to just tell yourself it will not work. But the need for self-motivation is for you to know that even when you hit the rocks of your life, even when you are in the valley level of your life, even when it looks as if God has left you, which he doesn't, he has never, even when it feels as if God has traveled, you should gird your loins like he used the case study of David. You should encourage yourself in the Lord. And what will make you encourage yourself in the Lord is when you know who you are and when you know whose you are. Am I communicating? Because when you know who you are, the fact that you have Jesus, who is your Father, then if you already have or had had a very cordial relationship with your earthly father, and you knew or you know how much he loves you, you know how much he won't let you drop on the ground, you know how much your shout or your scream won't let your father sit down, then you should be encouraged that God, who is the ultimate father, who is the supreme father, cannot and will not allow you to perish or to die in the state that you are finding yourself. Am I communicating? Motivation is needed when at that point in your life, it looks as if he read and Bible says darkness. Yes, darkness is everywhere. When you remember that indeed you are the light, and no matter how darkness is dark, no matter how bleak it is, darkness can never overcome the light. Therefore, you will never be overcome or be overtaken. Are you hearing me? Motivation is necessitated when you know that you are not an accident. You didn't just happen on the earth. God thought of you very much. He packaged you together and then he launched you on the earth. And because he's not a God that is purposeless, everything he does has a purpose. When you know that you are a child of purpose, when you know that it can't just be didier with you, when you know that you came for a purpose, and that purpose you must and will fulfill, you will encourage yourself in the Lord. You know, when David found himself in that situation, you know, David went through a lot of things. He had been anointed the king in three levels, three categories. At a point, the anointing sent him to the bush. He couldn't sleep again in homes like men slept. That anointing made him to be hiding in caves because someone was pursuing his life. And people who saw the vision that David had left everything and followed David. David's loyalists, David's friends, they followed him. But this very day, they were on a mission. People who were clapping for him, people who were waiting for him to succeed so they can align with him in purpose. This very day, the enemies had come. They packed everything, took everything, wives, children, belongings, everything. And David came with the men. The saddest of it all, which I want to hint on, is the men who supported David. David Christ were the ones who wanted to cast stones at David.